Manchester United versus FC Barcelona. See, the truth about this is this. Barcelona's weakness is in their coach, Xavi Hernandez. Manchester United's weakness is in their midfield, the lack of creativity there. These are two teams. One team, they have a great coach in Manchester United. They have a team that is somewhat okay, but not excellent. And then Barcelona, that on paper, they have an excellent team if the right 11 is starting, but the coach doesn't really know what he's doing. Now, this is going to be exciting. And this is why. First of all, you have Barcelona who have already failed. They failed in terms of the season. You can't have Lewandowski and Bayo Koundé and everyone like that and crash out in the Champions League. That is a failure. But on the other hand, you have a Manchester United team that's trying to regain their identity and trying to regain themselves. If you look at the starting 11 of Barcelona, this is their strongest 11. Ter Stegen in the post, left back has to be Jordi Alba, right back has to be Baldi. Baldi can play both the left and right back. In the center, as a center back pairing, has to be Koundé and Araujo. In the middle has to be, of course, Frankie de Jong, Kessié and Pedri. On the left up front has to be Ansu Fati. In the middle has to be Lewandowski. On the right has to be Ousmane Dembele. Manchester United, if they go with a 4-2-3-1 system, has to be, look at the left back, Malaysia has to start that game. Luke Shaw, the point is off and on, is not realistic. So Malaysia, right back has to be Diallo, center back pairing has to be Martinez and Varane. Of course, the two people in front of them, the two pivots, have to be Casemiro. And of course, Eriksen in front of them has to be Bruno Fernandes. On the left has to be Rashford. On the right has to be Antony. And in the middle has to be the big man, Cristiano Ronaldo. Now, the truth about this is this. When you look at the gameplay that Barcelona employs, which is tiki-taka, and then they go from the wings and try to cross into the box, the reason of starting Ansu Fati is to ensure that Lewandowski is not enclosed so much. And because of Ansu Fati's goal threat, the defenders have to pay attention to him, leaving Lewandowski open and open for the goal. But the truth about this is this. This is not going to be a joke of a match. Barcelona have a point to prove. You bought all these players and you've crashed down disgracefully to the Europa. And then you have Manchester United who want to show that they can actually do something, that they have an identity, that they have a structure, that they have a foresight and insight and the tenacity to do what they're supposed to do. This match is going to be an epic match. But I believe, if you look at in context, I believe that Xavi is still going to start Sergio Busquets in the middle. He's still going to start Frankie de Jong and he's going to start Pedri. And that's going to hurt Barcelona at the end of the day. And he's up front. He might not start Fati, Lewandowski and Ousmane Dembele. It might be Ferran Torres, Lewandowski and, of course, Ousmane Dembele, which is going to hurt Barcelona too. In context, Barcelona have come to a point whereby the coach really might be the one that kicks Barcelona out of the Europa. But if everything is done right, if the right team is started, if the right structure is applied, if everything is done rightly, I believe Barcelona just has the edge to remove Manchester United out of the Europa. But again, I don't trust Xavi, the Barcelona coach. And this game can go either way, depending on how Xavi employs what he has. Because truthfully and realistically, the Barcelona team is a better team than Manchester United team. That's the truth. But the coach is the weakest point. Manchester United, their creativity is the weakest point. But Bruno Fernandes can solve that on the day and bring what they need. And this game can go either ways.